guys, welcome back to the Rooted in Jesus podcast. I am Sheridan, and today we're going to be talking about something that people may get mad about, but I'm going to talk about it. I've been seeing some upsetting posts on Instagram, and I just thought this needs to be talked about in a loving, God-centered way, and people need to hear this because we need to be united as a church. Because God is coming soon, and we need to be the light to this dark world that we're living in. So, I guess let's just get on into the podcast. Okay, so on Instagram today, I was just looking on Instagram, just doing my normal thing. And then I come across some posts about masks. And basically, one was a meme, and then I came across some other stuff about mask, and I saw a few other things the past few weeks about mask and stuff like that, but basically it's really, really sad that Christians are acting this way. But basically it is people that are Christians that basically say that if you wear a mask you have no faith in God to protect you. So it's really crazy, and I really don't agree with that, because when you're saying that, it's like you're saying, I'm better than you because I don't wear a mask, you know? And that's not right, and that's not how God would want us to act. And we should do everything in love and kindness. And everybody is entitled to their own opinion. That's okay, everybody can have their own opinion, but we need to do it in a loving way, especially we as Christians, because this world is so dark right now. And we are the light of the world, and God called us to be light, and He called us to share love, and to share love to the lost. And we can't do that when we're fighting about, like, masks. We have to be love and light in this world, because there's so many people who are still lost, and Jesus is coming soon. For me personally, if you want to know if I wear a mask or if I don't wear a mask or whatnot, I'll just let you know, I personally wear a mask, and why do I do that? And I want you guys to respect my decision if you don't wear a mask, because I'm not going to tell you what to do, and you shouldn't tell me what to do. All I can do is what I feel is right in my heart, and you need to respect that. And me, I don't feel, you know, like this is something wrong and something that I shouldn't do, and I'm in a good relationship with the Lord, and God would convict me if there was something wrong with wearing a mask. So just so you know, that's where I'm coming from. And I encourage you guys to be respectful in the comments, if you guys are on YouTube. But anyways, I personally do wear a mask. And why do I do that? Well, when all this started, I thought wearing a mask is not just for me, it's for whoever else, you know, has underlying health conditions. And, you know, masks are not 100% protective, you know. They're not guaranteed, and I know that. But I still do it because I feel like that's the right thing to do in my heart. And I have asthma, so I'm trying my best to protect myself. Even if I know it's not guaranteed and it's not 100% effective, I know that. I try to also do that to protect me and my family members. And I just feel like that's the right thing to do in my heart. And I don't think we as Christians should judge other Christians because they're wearing a mask. It's just not right, and it's not godly, and it's just not a thing that God called us to do. God knows we're human. Even if you're wearing a mask because you're scared to death and you have a relationship with God, there's many Christians that deal with anxiety. There's many Christians that deal with depression and things like that. But just because we deal with fear and anxiety and stuff like that, and maybe that has something to do with why people and Christians are wearing masks, but it's not our job to judge them for being afraid. And God knows that we are human and we have fears. And He knows that. And also with wearing a mask, you as a Christian, I gotta ask you something too. You as a Christian, if you like have like medical issues like me, I have a thyroid issue and I take my thyroid medication. Does that mean that I have no faith in God? You know? If you have diabetes and you take your insulin and stuff, does that mean you have no faith in God? You wear a seatbelt in your car. Does that mean you have no faith in God? If you have asthma and you use your inhaler, does that mean you have no faith in God? There's so many things that we as humans need medicine. A lot of us Christians are on medications. Does that mean we have no faith in God? Absolutely not. We still have faith in God. We just realize that God has given doctors wisdom to prescribe us medicines that help us. You know? And just like a seatbelt will protect you if you have a car accident, will it 100% protect you if you have a car accident? No. But if you have that seatbelt on, when you're in the car and you have a car accident, that seatbelt will help you not get as bad injuries. Just like maybe the mask might not be 100% effective, but it might help just a little bit, you know? So that's how I see it, and I want you guys to look at it from that perspective. So for me, I'm going to be open, and I'm going to share my heart, and I'm going to share my feelings on things. And I don't want you guys to be watching my channel blindly, you know, and not knowing exactly what I'm doing and all that stuff. But for me personally, I am still allowed to go to church, you know, in my area. But I'm being a little cautious right now and watching online church. So another thing too that I think Christians are doing right now, especially in the church too, could be, if you're able to go to a physical church service and your church is open and you're allowed to go there and you decide to just do online church instead, some Christians may say, you have zero faith because you're just watching online church. And the same thing is, no, if we had zero faith, I don't think we would even be watching online church. It just makes zero sense to me. And me personally, I'm doing my best, and I'm doing what I feel is right and best, and I personally don't think Jesus is saying, Sheridan, you are a terrible person because you just do online church instead of going to the actual church building. I don't think he's saying that to me. And we as Christians should not be pointing our fingers at people if they're not at church and they're just doing online church. We shouldn't be judging and pointing our fingers and saying, you're a terrible person because you have no faith in God because you're just doing online church. So that's all I wanted to say about those two things. So now I'm going to talk about unity in the church. We need to be united. And by the way, I want to just say this. I love you no matter if you wear a mask or you don't wear a mask. You know, I love you anyways. And Jesus loves you. And he has a plan and he has a purpose for your life. And he wants you to follow him with all that you are. And he wants you to draw near to him. Because when we do that, he will draw near to us. And he wants that relationship with you. And guys, I just want to tell you, God is coming soon. He's coming soon for our church. It is so evident in our world. The church is divided about little crazy things. There's so much craziness going on in the world. We see crazier things each day. It's just so evident that God is coming soon. So I encourage y'all to be ready. But us as the church, especially in the last days, we need to be united. Because if we're not united as the body of Christ and as the church, it's going to be hard for the unbelievers to see our light. Because we're going to be, our eyes are so clouded by the little things that are not that big of a deal. So I'm going to get into some scriptures and into some verses about being united, but let's get on into that. We're going to be reading in Ephesians, and this is Ephesians 4, verses 1 through 6. I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you to walk worthy of the calling which you were called, with all lowliness and gentleness, and long-suffering, bearing with one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called, in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and one Father of all, who is above all, and through all, and in you all. So basically, this verse is telling us to walk worthy in the calling which God called us to, and to be humble, and to be gentle, and to love one another, and to have unity in the Spirit, and we are one body. And God is in us all of us Christians, God is in us. And God wants us to be unified. God does not want us to be divided by little things. God wants us to be united. And especially in the last days, we need that unity in the church. Because if we don't have unity in the church, it's going to be so hard for lost people to see our light. Because they're going to see that there's so many little things that's dividing the church that they're going to be like, do I really want to be a part of that? They're already so divided, you know? We need to seek Christ and to seek what God wants above all else and to do our best to love one another no matter if we have little different choices here and there. Okay, so the next thing that we are going to be reading is 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 8 and 9. Finally, all of you live in harmony with one another. Be sympathetic. Love as brothers, be compassionate and humble. Do not repay evil with evil or insult with insult, but with blessing, because of this you were called, so that you may inherit a blessing. But we're supposed to be loving, and we're supposed to show each other love as brothers and sisters in Christ, not to try to tear each other down and to make each other feel bad for differing choices that, you know, there's not a perfect answer on what to do. Times are hard and it's hard to figure out what to do and what is right. You just have to go with what you feel is right in your heart, and you gotta pray to God about it and figure it out for yourself what God is speaking to your heart to do in the situation. Whatever differing opinions we may have, we gotta love each other just like Christ loved us. And now we're gonna read 1 Peter verses 4, 7, and 8. The end of all things is near. Therefore, be clear-minded and self-controlled so that ye may pray. Above all, love each other deeply, because love covers a multitude of sins. So basically it says, the end is near, therefore be clear-minded and self-controlled, so that ye may pray. Above all, love each other deeply, because love covers a multitude of sins. So we as Christians need to love each other, even though we might not agree 100% on what we should do in this time. Just give grace, extend that grace to somebody. It's not easy living in this crazy world that we live in right now. And we as Christians need to extend grace to Christians that may have different opinions than we have on certain things. And we just need to respect their choices, because most Christians are going to do what they feel is right in their heart. And some Christians are not going to do that. They're going to just go with whatever they want to go with. But me, personally, I've went to the Lord in prayer about these things, and I'm doing what I feel is right. And you should do the same. Okay, so I'm going to read this verse. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of a low position. Do not be conceited. Do not repay anyone evil for evil. We're just supposed to be kind and loving. Just love. That's what we're called to do as Christians. And I hope those verses helped you out and helped you see, no matter what end of the spectrum you're on, we're called to love, even if we don't agree 100%, you know? Guys, the whole point of this podcast was not to make anybody mad or anything like that. It was just basically to say to love one another as Christians, no matter what end of the spectrum you're on. As far as that issue that I spoke about, just to love one another and to pray about your decisions and pray that God leads you in the right decision making when it comes to that stuff, just like I prayed about it. You guys may not agree with me, and that's okay. I still love you and God loves you. I want to close this podcast with saying we as Christians, we need to be the light of the world. We need to be seeking to shine our light. However we can do that, we need to shine our light and to love on our fellow believers and to do our best to just try to just be the light. Yeah, just be the light. But guys, I encourage you to try your best to seek God because the Lord is coming soon. We are living in the end of time. We need to just seek Him with all that we are and to try to do our best to live out what He's called us to do and to try to make disciples. And that's what we need to be doing right now. So I pray that this touched you in some way, and I pray that you understand where I'm coming from. And you see, we need unity in the church, and we need unity in this world because this world is going down a bad path, a path of destruction, and we need to do our best to be the light because there's so many still lost in this world that need Jesus, so we need to just be shining that light. I encourage you, be ready, seek God with all that you are, read the Bible, draw near to God, and He will draw near to you. So that's my little encouragement, but I love you guys, and be the light to this world, because this world needs light. It needs light. There's too much darkness right now, but I love you guys, and I'll see you guys in the next podcast. Bye!